When you think you're done with your Flash project, you still need to be able to publish it. Publishing allows people who don't own Adobe Flash Professional to view the file with their free Adobe Flash player. So this project is a solar system game, and I want to publish it to put it on the web. Right now, it's an FLA file, and most people don't own the program because it's quite expensive, and so they won't be able to view it in this format. So instead, I need to go up to the File menu and go to Publish Settings and choose the different types of formats that I want it to publish as. Right now, it's going to publish as default Swift file and an HTML wrapper. And for the majority of the time, this is what you're going to want. Now, you also have the option to export it as image formats or Win and Mac Projector. What I recommend you do is go to the Flash Help and type in Publish Settings and see what each of these settings does. For now, we're going to focus on the default of the Swift file and the HTML wrapper. For the Swift file, you can change what free Flash player it can target. So if you know that your audience isn't very tech savvy and they're less likely to have the latest version of Flash, you might want to start out with a lower level of Flash. Or if you know it's going to be something that's going to be on an Android device or an iOS device, then you can choose those here. In addition, there are a bunch of different Swift settings that you can mess with, but in general, what is set is what you're going to need. If we go to the HTML wrapper, there's a couple things you need to know. First, it's going to say that it has center alignment, and so far, it's never actually worked for me. And you can change what the quality is of the project, and you can have a different size, you can have it loop, you can do all kinds of different stuff with the HTML. One thing that you need to make sure is that both for the Swift and the HTML, if they're actually going to go online, that your output file has no capital letters, no spaces, and no weird characters like an exclamation point. Websites like to have file format that doesn't have any of those things. So now that I have the two files that I want, I can hit publish. And if I go into my projects folder, now in addition to my Flash file, I have a Swift file and an HTML file. So let's go ahead and double click the HTML file, and it's going to open it up. And there's my solar system game. Now, it is an HTML file, and within that file, the Swift is embedded. That's what this is right here. So you need to make sure that the Swift file and the HTML file always stay together and always in the same level. Don't try to put the Swift in a folder and HTML in a folder, because then the file paths will be incorrect and it won't work. So keep them together all the time. And also, for your project, you need to make sure to keep all of your assets. So here's my Illustrator file of the planets. Here's a picture of the order of the planets and the font I used and the audio I used. That way that none of the links will break. So the last thing I want to show you is that you can update the HTML so that it truly does sit in the center no matter how big or small their window gets. And right now my background is white, and that's because in Flash, my stage color is actually white. It doesn't look like it because I just have a background that's a black square, because sometimes I don't want my whole page to be black. So if I did want my whole page to be black, I could choose the stage color and black. But just for the sake of this, I'll just do a dark gray or kind of a medium gray so you can see the difference. Now if I go to File and hit Publish, I don't have to go to Settings all the time, but I can hit Publish and refresh this, and now you can see that dark gray. So now I just need to center that HTML file. I can minimize Flash, and I just need to be able to open that HTML file up in an HTML editor. So I'll right click on it and choose Open With. Now if you're on a PC, you can use Notepad, which is a free application that comes with PCs, and you'll be able to edit the HTML. And Apple users, you should be able to use text edit, but you have to go through a couple of extra steps so it'll show you the actual code. But anything you right click here, you might be able to edit with. So I can edit with my Adobe Dreamweaver Or if you're on a PC, you can download the free Notepad++. And if you're on a Mac, there's a free program called Text Wrangler, and those are all really good programs. So I'll just open this up in Dreamweaver. And this is what it actually looks like on the page. So I'll go to the code, and this is what we're looking for. We're looking for the HTML code here. In order to make it sit in the center, I'm going to find the div with the ID of flash content. So look for that in your code. Yours might not be color coordinated like mine is for ease of reading. So just look through here and it should be right after body. So after the flash content, and it has a little quote right there, I'm going to type align equals quote center and then close the quote. So this attribute is going to tell it that whatever is in this divider should be centered. So I'll click File, Save. And now when I open up that HTML file, we should see it centered. Now, if you know anything about web design or HTML or CSS, you can definitely do some CSS in here to make it sit away from the top of the page, or to make it sit vertically and horizontally in the center. You can do all kinds of CSS. You can add a heading. You can add text down here if you wanted to. But if you don't know any HTML, as long as you can open it up in an editor and in the div ID of flash content, you give it the attribute of align equals quote center close quote, then you should be fine. And make sure that is inside of this little bracket right here, or angle bracket.